What's up, Phoenix Nation? We're back. It's Thursday, September 20th. We got a great show lined up for you today. But first, homecoming. You'll be voting for your homecoming nominees today, so get those ballots back to your advisor and let's get on with the show. We're going to take a look at those dress-up days for homecoming week, which starts October 22nd. We got Monday, which is sports attire. It's home run day. Tuesday, it's make yourself at home. You can wear your PJs. Wednesday, home of the brave. It's anything patriotic. Thursday, it's home away from home, it's tourist attire. Friday, there's no place like home, and we got our spirit wear. Go ahead and get everything ready. Let's make it a great homecoming to remember.
Falling too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling as vultures. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run, I was born for this. Whip.
Maddie Poppy is a 20-year-old American singer-songwriter from Clarksville, Iowa. She can play multiple instruments, with her main genres being pop music and folk music. She has been a fan of the American Idol ever since she was a child. Her father pushed her to audition once the show came back. Her father was successful. She ended up auditioning for American Idol.
Songs about rainbows and what's on the other side.
The winner of American Idol is Maddie Poppy. Congratulations, Maddie.
I'm about to paint all of you guys right here right now.
Good.
It's a red foot.
It's almost like I'm not.
You act like we like either
because
foot.
I'm
Just a reminder, Jandy's will be here tomorrow, so make sure to go by and grab a cup.
Hey guys, Tim here. I want to be walking around asking students what their opinion is on the school dress code. Let's see what they have to say.
I feel like you should get to wear booty shorts if you would like, but not where you can see the cheeks, because that would be dress code, no doubt. But like at least up to like right there.
See, it doesn't.
It's dumb. We should wear anything we should want to wear.
What makes you say that?
Because we can wear anything. It's freedom.
Good. Opinion on dress code, like male dress code or female?
In general.
I mean, I like it for the most part. I think it's reasonable.
It could get better.
Yeah.
Shorter shorts.
Is there anything like about the dress code that you would like to change?
I wish they'd let us wear Speedos.
No, God! No, God, please, no! 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 No!
It's stupid.
What makes you say that?
Because some people's like clothing items. I mean, you gotta go buy out and buy new stuff. I mean, sometimes you just don't have the money to buy new clothes. And you gotta wear what you gotta wear.
What you just said
is one of the most insanely idiotic things I have ever heard. At no point in your rambling, incoherent response were you even close to anything that could be considered a rational thought. Everyone in this room is now dumber for having listened to it. I award you no points, and may God have mercy on your soul.
What is your opinion on the dress code?
Well, I agree on certain things, like you have to be covered in certain areas, but I mean, what you gonna show off around your kneecaps? Like,
I agree with it.
Why?
It gives the school some class.
To Shadows. I'm here with
Ethan,
James,
and Justin.
And who do you want to shout out?
Snowville.
Why?
It's a good school.
I want to shout out myself, you know, because I'm amazing. Oh, add me on Snapchat, James finished 12.
I want to shout out my coach, Coach Stewart, being a good coach, always been there.
He was, wasn't he?
All right, there you go.
Allie.
And Jada.
To Justin and Uriel for being real ones.
Yeah, them, real ones.
Coach MacArthur.
And who do you want to shout out?
Megan and Jenna Palazzolo. Definitely not Miss Palazzolo, though. Not Miss Palazzolo.
But why do you want to shout them out?
Because they're awesome. All
right. Dallas Smith.
And she'd like to give a shout out, too.
Emily Swafford for being a great friend.
There you go.
Oh. I'm here with
Raven.
Kaylee.
Don't.
And Kelsey.
D-Mac.
Coach Pay, I love you.
Coach Hughes.
And why?
D-Mac's just like my best friend. I love him so much.
Coach Pay is the best weight training coach ever.
Mm-hmm. And Coach Schuster is like very encouraging. And yeah.
Emily Buis.
And she'd like to give a shout out to
Megan Hafner.
Why?
Because I love her.
Trent Bohannon.
Who do you want to give a shout out to?
Coach Perch
and Coach Stewart.
All right, why?
They're there for you.
This is Gage Mullins reporting from Channel 2 Action News. We got
Fernanda.
And she's about to do a shout out for real this time. Ready? Yeah. Who'd you like to shout out?
I'd like to shout out my homies, Yuri, Genesis, Emily, Kathy, Leslie, and the Raider team, because you know we got seventh place this week and we did really good. So yeah, shout out to the Raider team too. Because we're cool like that.
Yeah, she should have been a rapper.
Smith. And?
Garrison Mullins.
And who do you guys want to shout out?
I want to shout out my big brother Gage because he's diabetic.
Thanks for showing us so much about videoing and making us the person we are right now.
Person right now.
Oh, and then. We can.
Senara. Las cosas buenas. Papa.
We're back at it here again. All right. So, yeah, no, we've been giving shout-outs to everybody. Oh, no.
Shout-out to Yurima.
No, you're recording. Oh.
There's a lot of movies coming out in 2018. The first movie I'm going to be talking about is Smallfoot. Smallfoot is an upcoming animated movie directed by Carrie Kirkpatrick, which tells the story of a young yeti named Migo, who discovers a life form he didn't think existed. Smallfoot releases on September 28, 2018.
We're going to be safe here, nice and warm.
Ah, no!
How's that?
Nice and toasty all the way around.
Oh, hey, what's wrong? You hungry? I found your food.
Please!
The next movie I'm going to be talking about is Night School. Night School is an upcoming comedy movie written by Kevin Hart, which tells the story of a young man who dropped out of high school and now he is forced to take a night school to get his GED. Night School also releases on September 28, 2018.
My suspicions were correct.
Boom!
You're clinically dumb.
There is no cure for what you have.
Oh my God! I got learning herpes? I got the gift to keep on giving? Boy.
My name is Justin Bonds, and I'm the producer of Ignite. My job here is to manage everyone's productivity and time management so that we can produce a successful show every other Thursday. The first two episodes of Ignite have been relatively successful, and we're constantly improving to make a better show every other week. I'm really confident in this class to turn out great videos. I look forward to seeing what we can accomplish in the future.
Ignite was an idea that we came up with last semester in the spring. It was a different name, we called it The Ember, and it was a concept that we came up with that really was geared towards students, and the kind of approach we took last semester was not successful. And this summer I really took an initiative into really coming up with a concept that worked for the class. My role in this class is really as an advisor kind of role. I don't take a teacher approach to this class of my advanced level students. I treat it like a business. They get assignments, they get these segments they're responsible for, they get a linked amount of time to do them, and they have a deadline to meet. And it's really a showcase of what they can do. And it's really evident in our show of what some of them are truly capable of. A lot of fun, a lot of stress, but it's a different experience than one I've ever created, and two, I think that anybody's ever had in here. And it's kind of a unique situation.
I'm Peter Clance, and I'm one of the entertainment producers for Ignite. We've started a show before, which was The Ember of last year, our mistakes with it and what we needed to improve on. This past summer, when we were all off for break, Coach Huff decided that he was going to take certain points that he liked about The Ember and basically redo them. That's what kind of became Ignite. There's been a lot of hard work put into this, and I'm really excited to see what happens.
Hey, no running in the hallway.
What is this place? And who are you?
Hey, friend.
Hope you guys enjoyed the show. If you like this, remember to like, comment, and subscribe. And if you're new here, to go follow.
Live in 10.
Look at that. What the heck, dude?
Sorry.
Hey, you, buddy. Listen here.
I didn't mean to interrupt your shot.
Every time you interrupt it, I'll shake you.